Tom, I think you should light the hallway because Diana has placed us as part of the entourage so you can follow with a minicam, all right? Dr. Walker, excuse me. Dr. Walker. Kristine Walsh, we met in Palm Springs, Gerald Ford's. Well, I've been such an admirer of yours, I wanted to see.
I remember you, Ms. Walsh. You were a newswoman.
Well, I'm still a newswoman.
No, Ms. Walsh. I don't know what you are, but you're certainly not a newswoman. At best, a press secretary, at worst, a collaborator.
I don't know what you've been told, Dr. Walker, but I'm just doing my job.
Well, familiar words. I wonder how many times that phrase was used at the Nuremberg trials.
That is insulting and untrue.
Ms. Walsh, I'll tell you what is untrue. It is untrue that you're working for a benevolent regime. It is untrue that you're an impartial journalist. What's true is that fascists have taken over our planet, and you're their minister of propaganda. You're a discredit to your profession. You've allowed personal ambition to corrupt your integrity, and you no longer have credibility. Good day.
Dr. Kaufman to OR. Dr. Kaufman to OR, please.
Dr. Walker, we've been waiting for you.
I trust you'll have the president ready for the interview, and soon.
It would be much easier if I was supervising the conversion process personally. But tough as he is, I'm told he'll be ours in a day or two.
It's taking too long, Diana.
Conversion can be a long and difficult process, John. It can't be rushed.
Kristine is losing faith in us.
It's not as simple to tap their minds as it is their water resources. One mistake and our Nobel laureate, Dr. Walker, will be a babbling idiot.
This way.
Ah, Kristine. Thank you for coming in before your broadcast. I want you to meet your guest before the show.
Splendid. Who is it?
One of the most honorable and respected men in your country. And I am delighted to say, a regular booster for us. I know how pleased he is to be appearing with you tonight.
Kristine Walsh, what a pleasure. I wonder if you remember that we met once before, Gerald Ford's home. We played bridge, I think, after golf. You and Betty made a six-club bid I would have thought impossible, but you carried it off brilliantly. You gave us quite a bridge lesson. I do want to take this opportunity to tell you, too, what a wonderful job we all think you're doing. It's so important that we have people like you